Hey guys, so today I'm going to be looking at more Emma Rung stories. So yeah, let's just get right into the video. My daughter Jenny has a best friend Morgan, nearly 13. The two of them spend a lot of time together at our place. I do not know Morgan's mother very well, as Jenny doesn't often go to their house. This is mainly because Morgan's house is a little chaotic. She has four siblings. Jenny is an only child, and Morgan has said she likes the quiet. Morgan has done a lot of stuff with us. I occasionally enter radio and online competitions and will win tickets to certain local events. When I won four tickets to a concert last year, Jenny and I brought Morgan along with another friend. We all had a blast. Recently, I won another pair of tickets to a concert that I planned to attend with Jenny. A few days later, I was told about a work trip that I have to take that falls that weekend. Jenny usually comes with me, so Jenny suggested we give the tickets to Morgan for her birthday. She could either go with another friend or her mom. I checked with Morgan's mom before we mentioned this to Morgan, and she said that was fine. Last night, Morgan was at our house and she seemed upset. When I asked her why, she said her mom was taking her brother to the concert because her brother has never been to a concert before. I asked if Morgan's brother even liked the band, and Morgan said no, it was just the principle of the matter. Morgan and her other three siblings have been going to concerts. He hasn't, and since they can't afford stuff like this, he gets to go. I found this unfair and honestly a waste of tickets. I called Morgan's mom to double check this story, and she confirmed it all, including her 11-year-old son, Billy, knowing anything about the band. I said, I'm sorry, but I don't feel right giving these as a birthday gift anymore, as these were for Morgan. I said we'll give them to Jenny and Morgan's other friend, who I know likes the band, and we'll get Morgan something else for her birthday. Morgan is fine with this. Morgan's mom is pissed and says I'm trying to tell her how to parent. I don't think I am, because if a different friend gave Morgan the tickets and it was the same result, as shitty as I'd find the mom doing this, I wouldn't say anything, as that's not my business. As I'm giving the tickets, I want them to go to Morgan. I'd also maybe feel different if the brother loved the band too, but as he doesn't, I don't want to give them. So here I am left wondering if I'm being the assie. Nope. Why is Morgan's mom giving Morgan's birthday present away? Seriously? Like, huh? Imagine receiving a concert ticket for your birthday and then your mom takes it and brings your brother without you. But those were your tickets. Oh, F that. Seriously, that's messed up. Wow, way to show someone that you don't like one of your kids. No wonder why Morgan hates hanging out at home. All right, moving on. One of my good friends, Matthew, is getting married next month to Jennifer, and I have known Matthew since high school. We've both connected when it came to video games, especially Minecraft. Matthew has had his fair share of girlfriends over the years, but when he met Jennifer 3 years ago, he said that he knew she was the one, and they are madly in love with each other, and I'm so happy for them both. Last year, Matthew popped the question to Jennifer, and she said yes. Jennifer's demeanor towards me drastically changed after the engagement. She was distant towards me. She wouldn't look at me and would hardly speak to me, which was weird, since Jennifer was always so sweet and nice towards me. I still talk to Matthew and meet with him and our group of friends, sometimes with Jennifer, and she would still act cold and not speak to me much. I kept my distance from Jennifer. 3 months ago, we all received a save-the-date invitation, and the wedding is going to take place at Matthew's cabin 2 hours away, and they're going to keep it small due to the size of the cabin, so we were only allowed to bring one guest. That was when Jennifer acted extremely harsh and hostile towards me and said, "But you don't have a plus one since you're so into my man." That's wild. I was taken aback. I asked her what the F she was talking about, and she smirked and said I knew and not to act stupid. I ignored her remark and told her my boyfriend was coming. She looked surprised and left. I of course told Matthew about what Jennifer said to me, and he was not happy, so he made her apologize to me. Wow, okay, well she just looks so dumb. I bet you don't have a plus one because you're so into my man. My boyfriend's coming. How are you jealous after your man proposed to you? That's crazy. Then last weekend, I was invited by Matthew's sister to go dress shopping with her and Jennifer. I declined at first because I wanted to keep my distance from Jennifer, but Matthew's sister assured me that she would deal with Jennifer and that our other friends would be there with us. So we go dress shopping, and I found a beautiful dress that I thought would be perfect, and I took a picture to send to my boyfriend since he planned on matching. I tried the dress on and it was a perfect fit, so I guess I got lucky. Jennifer was angry, called me names such as a whore, a boyfriend-stealing bitch, and that I was officially uninvited to the wedding. She caused such a commotion, the employee of the store asked us to leave. Is Jennifer okay? Dude, if I was Matthew, I would be thinking twice about marrying Jennifer. I told Jennifer I didn't want to come to the wedding anyway, but I was going to because my friend was getting married. I told her if she didn't want me at the wedding, fine, I don't care, since I won't go to a wedding if the bride is going to be so rude to a guest. Matthew and our friends found out, and I was getting texts left and right begging me to just come to the wedding. I told them I was happy to get uninvited and I'll just spend the day with my boyfriend on the day of the wedding instead. They're all mad at me for not fighting hard enough. Excuse me. This person was uninvited to the wedding. They can't just go. You know, they can't just still show up if they were uninvited. Like what? Do you want the wedding to be a disaster or something? If the bride doesn't want you there at the wedding, don't go. That's the right thing to do. Right? But I feel like something did go on behind the scenes. Because if Jennifer was so nice to this person before she got engaged, then someone must have told her something after she got engaged. Like, someone is behind the scenes trying to cause some drama, okay? Like, someone is secretly laughing. Someone is like, fight, fight, fight. So, there's something going on, and this person doesn't know, and Jennifer is just believing that person, and then the fiancé doesn't know, Matthew doesn't know what's going on. So, yeah, somebody is doing some work behind the backs. Because this is just wild. Like, no one would act this crazy like Jennifer if nobody told them anything, right? Someone must have been like, oh, this bitch likes your boyfriend. I saw her confess to him, blah, 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 right? That's why she's so mad. That's what I'm gonna believe. Because if Jennifer is just mad for no reason, then okay, she's crazy. But if she's believing what someone else is saying, then yeah, that's probably the reason why she's acting like this. I don't know. Well, there's an update. I met up with Matthew and brought my boyfriend along. Of course, he begged me to come to the wedding and he said he would beg Jennifer to let me attend. I told him it's best if I wasn't there. I told Matthew that Jennifer has a problem with me, period. He said he doesn't understand and he did ask her many times, but Jennifer would continue to say she was just stressed. I got angry and said that's bullshit and he knows that. My boyfriend also intervened and said to Matthew that he needs to wake up and realize Jennifer is crazy and he can't keep defending her. Matthew said he loves her too much and doesn't want to lose her. My boyfriend and I got up and told Matthew to let us know when he has the backbone. In the meantime, it's best we don't talk. I messaged all of our friends in the group to let them know I'm keeping a distance from Matthew because of Jennifer. He's still my friend, but at an arm's length. I'll still be sending him a gift regardless, but I'm keeping my distance from Matthew. It seems like he's in denial and can't comprehend what is going on at all. He usually is in denial. Ever since high school, he would have a sense of denial. Yeah, let everyone know. Let everyone know he's a bit crazy too. Another thing to mention is that Jennifer is nice to all of Matthew's female friends, just not with me. I've also gotten a message from two of our friends saying they have dropped out of the wedding because of Jennifer and they are on my side. Okay, so at least we all know that other people find Jennifer crazy too. Man, but I'm just really thinking, like, who's behind the scenes? Who's plotting, you know? I want to know. But yeah, I would be the same as this person. I wouldn't go. If the bride doesn't want me to go, then I'm not going. And you guys can be happy, and I'll be happy too. It's a win-win. Well, that's it for the video. Hope you guys enjoy. Tell me in the comments down below what your thoughts are. And as always, thanks for watching. Hope you guys liked it, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!